The science of where seems like a new phrase to many of you. It's actually an attempt to capture, get a sense of, describe the kinds of work that you do. You know, in the very beginning of GIS, almost from the very beginning, GIS was applied to science, to biology, to ecology, and to economics, and to social sciences of various types. But it wasn't until about 1993, I think it was, when Michael Goodchild wrote a paper called GI Science. I forget what the title was. Michael, you're here someplace in the audience, but I can't recall what it was. But it changed the game. The world began to realize that GIS is a science in its own right. It incorporates many other sciences, like geography, data science, analytics, modeling, computer science, the science of visualization, decision support science. It actually integrates all of these, it's like a meta-science. Well, without going too abstract on you, I'll also simply say, what is it? What is the science of where? Simply stated, it's the science of geography and the technology of GIS. And those maps, those examples that I showed you over the last couple of minutes are the evidence that this is a science, this is a framework for applying science. The science of where is a framework for applying science to almost everything. That's a very powerful notion for me. So why is this science so important right now? I'll suggest a couple of reasons. The first one is you and I are living at a time in a world which is increasingly challenged. And we see this, we hear this, we read about it. Growing population, some people would say overpopulation. The issues of climate change, loss of nature, social conflicts. These are not trivial things, ladies and gentlemen. These are for us as individuals, perhaps troubling, and also our organizations, because our organizations, the organizations that you work in, are all being confronted with this evolving, changing world. And for me, the evidence is quite clear. We're going to have to do everything we possibly can to better understand, as Richard Saul Wurman would say, and also form better collaboration. Gowdy's quote, get close, collaborate, all of us together, to address these things in exactly the kind of style that UPS made their tremendous advancements doing. Our world at the same time is undergoing a massive digital transformation. We are automating everything, as Jack's presentation showed. We're measuring everything that moves and changes with satellites and drones and the IoT, and we're wiring them together, a kind of fabric across the planet. Our field, the science of where, is providing our world with a fundamental language. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your language. And that language is all about understanding and also managing inside of organizations and between and among organizations, the future of the planet. And it doesn't really matter where you are in the stack of things. GIS provides us not simply a language, but it provides us a fundamental framework wherein we can organize our maps and our data. We can integrate it. We can do all the data compilation and then visualize it and analyze the relationships and patterns. We can do predictive analytics. We can also do design and planning on it. We can make decisions based on it and then take those into action. And from my perspective, this seems like the only technology that actually has a shot at being able to address those very challenges that you and I are facing as individuals. It has the opportunity and is implementing in many of your organizations the concept of transforming how we think and how we actually carry out our thinking into action, creating a more sustainable future. And that's a high aspiration. I suppose it's a high aspiration for you. It's particularly a high aspiration for me. Can we make a difference with our work and turn this around? And my view is, yes, we can. Now, GIS is a technical platform. We know it. All of you are the practitioners of this platform for managing, analyzing, and applying geographic information. It's a practical platform for managing our systems of record, whether they be small in small communities or organizations or businesses, or mammoth like NGA, managing the system of record for the planet's topographic information. GIS is also a system of engagement for interacting with people, and at its heart, it's a system of insight where we can do spatial analytics, look at relationships, see things in whole. We can approach problem solving in a more holistic way because this platform integrates people and processes and all the data about them. Isn't that just an amazing notion that you, ladies and gentlemen, are working with all the dimensions of information and using the power of where to integrate it? This is what keeps me awake at night, this technology notion that is so impactful across our organizations. And I suppose you're aware of it. It's changing rapidly with all the new data sources, floods of data, and the advances in computing, not just faster machines, but also whole new architectures, distributed computing, machine learning, microservices on the horizon. And then there's the GIS innovation itself, which we'll see a lot of in the next few hours and days. This is ramping up. I like to call this ramp up, this pattern, a web GIS pattern. And my sense, this momentum is going to expand your ability and power to be able to apply the science everywhere. This WebGIS pattern is a modern GIS architecture. I'll say it is the modern GIS architecture. It's not only conceptually interesting, it's actually helping you do your work better, and that's the bottom line initially for me. It's using web services, leveraging web services to integrate teams and individuals and departments and actually whole organizations with shared knowledge and therefore collaboration. So this is, I would say, improving productivity and efficiency. And that pattern is just taking off. I'll show you some statistics of it in a few minutes, but it's, some people object to me saying this, but it's growing exponentially. My good friend Mariana keeps saying, "No, Jack, that has mathematical meanings." Yes, I know it does, but I have to tell you that it's growing exponentially. WebGIS simplifies working with all types of data. I want to tell you why it's growing. First, it simplifies working with data. It brings data together. I would say it normalizes data. That's the wrong word, but by using web maps and web scenes and web layers, it can access any kind of data type, imagery, maps, real-time data, LiDAR, into a common language. Speaking about real-time, real-time information is where it's going. The complexity of our cities and our nature, well, they're being wired up with things like the IoT. We can stream in information now and not take old geologic maps that don't change very often. No, the maps are alive, recognizing the complexity and situations that we're dealing with. And this isn't just a map. Now we're dealing with real-time information and able to do space-time work in meaningful ways. Apps are bringing GIS to life in many ways. It's bringing the power of GIS to everyone, extending the reach to field people, connecting them to their organization, and business apps, and viewer apps, and social media, and story maps, and dashboards. across your organizations and beyond. Smart mapping, the innovation of using computation and logic to create maps automatically, as well as exploratory data analysis, are simplifying the use of analytics, but also just opening up the opportunity for everyone to create really beautiful maps and understand things better. This WebGIS pattern is also affecting my old field, the planning and design field. It's changing how designers think and do their work. It's integrating science right into the design process. People now can get data off the web as services, do interactive designs, look at scenarios, analyze them, evaluate the consequences of them, and then share, disseminate the results. WebGIS is not only helping you do your work better, it's also advancing analytics and geo-enabling data science. It's advancing analytics in the sense that it's opening up new tools like for exploratory data analysis, and we'll see this later today. It's also opening up or geo-enabling data science by new innovations like a Python API that can be integrated directly into the toolbox of data scientists, doing R integration, and just frankly providing analytic services open for not just the GIS professional, but across the board types of analysts. WebGIS is also connecting everybody, the sort of system of engagement with identities, people connecting with their organizations, and with our community in real time. This is supporting not just quick communication, but also new forms of collaboration using mapping as a way to engage and talk with each other, to carry on a conversation. And speaking about communities, WebGIS is beginning to engage community engagement. Is that the right way to say it? It's beginning to enable community engagement. It's organizing and managing all the little community interactions. Our work in the city of Los Angeles with something called the GIS Hub is making this very clear to us that citizens want more information about their city. And leaders, the managers, the mayor, wants to hear from the citizens. They want more input. So we've been working on technology, which I'll share a little bit later today, around policy initiatives, where we can stand up with GIS a set of policy initiatives that communicate with citizens and get their feedback, crowdsourced engagement. More about that later in a moment or two. What I've been trying to describe, what I'm trying to sense from these explanations, what I'm trying to explain from these explanations is that there's change occurring within our community. I hope you guys get a sense of it and appreciate it. That we think, I'm beginning especially to think, that GIS is going to enable a whole new scale of GIS, interconnecting our separate systems with web services, expanding collaboration at the technical level and with shared services, and creating systems of systems. And we already see it, not just within organizations like a city is sharing between planning and engineering departments, but take, for example, in Las Vegas, the water agency there is now sharing their information with the utilities. And they're doing this as web services. So in the work of utility organizations, they don't dig where they shouldn't. Doesn't that make sense? I mean, sharing information across and between organizations. Senator Rich on our Capitol Hill is now sharing geographic data with the state of Idaho and back and forth. Politicals, agencies, agency to agency, across the US federal agencies, across many cities and departments. This pattern is beginning to emerge. Let me pause for a moment and simply give my sense of what all this means. GIS is now capable. It now provides the means to do your work better. That's clearly where we're focused. And also for you to apply the full, like Lauren showed, the full power of the science aware everywhere. Everywhere inside your organization and beyond. So this excites me.